Now, time is running out. The D-Day is coming up very soon. That we need the decision makers, the state government and the Premier, to use common sense and protect the Great Artesian Basin for all the communities that rely on that all through Queensland. And we see that as a huge risk, because within our community, we rely on the Great Artesian Basin 100%, and we cannot risk that for our sustainability. All water is used for agriculture, drinking water. All the water that we access in the Murway Shire is based from the Great Artesian Basin.
The Great Artesian Basin, in my view, has come under attack from corporate Australia in terms of the mining industry looking to contaminate what is an iconic water supply. In my view, the Great Artesian Basin is non-negotiable when it comes to utilising it as a dumping point for carbon impacted water.
Well, this is one of the most blatant attempts of ineptitude and arrogance I've ever come across. They're going to try and poison our well, potentially poison our well. There is no proof that this will not backfire on storing CO2 in any aquifer anywhere near the Great Artesian Basin. It's also an international issue where Glencore are saying it's perfectly acceptable in Europe and other places. Well, it's not acceptable in America, and I doubt that it's all that acceptable in Europe, which is why they're out here looking to store it out here. It is a blatant attempt to poison, to potentially poison our well without any inside information, outside scientific proof that it's 100% guaranteed. If you poison our well, we can't drink it. 60% of the landmass of Queensland drink the water straight from the Artesian Basin. Drink it. The tourists, the animals, the people, the crops, the whole infrastructure of rural industry in inland Australia on top of the Great Artesian Basin depend on the Great Artesian Basin. You poison it and we're out of there. It's very simple. Don't do it. This is obviously one that's slipped past the keeper and gone to the boundary. People don't understand the Great Artesian Basin. They don't understand the importance of it. They've been to school, to uni, to a policy advisor's job in Parliament House, and the politicians were badly advised. And they're badly advised anyway, because they've gone from school to uni to Parliament. Get out there and look at what's making the world around you tick. They're not doing it. And this is one of the most dangerous things I think I've ever come across. It's quite unbelievable. Quite unbelievable. And we need an answer pretty quickly from federal, particularly the state in our case, but then the federal government. And it needs to go worldwide. You can't do that to people. You can't poison people's wells.
Our Toowoomba water supply for a couple of our townships is heavily reliant. In fact, it's totally reliant on the Great Artesian Basin for drinking water, and therefore to have not that not available or have it reduced in its quality would be absolutely diabolical for those townships. And we're talking a couple of thousand people. We also service our agricultural sector with the Great Artesian Basin, and namely the Grassdale feedlot of Morton Co, which is the largest feedlot in Australia. Some 70,000 units, cattle units, and they employ, you know, over 100 people. So again, just tinkering with the Great Artesian Basin, with any level of risk of what it could end up like, unknown, the unknown, is just not worth it. It's not worth the risk. So therefore, we're fully supportive of the notion of not tinkering with the Great Artesian Basin.
Well, for us, our community is 100% reliant on the GAB for potable water, of course, in our communities, but much more broader than that. Our agricultural producers rely on this, you know, beautiful resource, you know, very important resource, and it needs to be protected at all costs. I suspect there's a lot of work to be done to highlight how, you know, important and reliant their Western cousins are on the GAB. Without it, our communities would not survive. And, you know, we need to implore governments to step up and back in communities that do rely so heavily on the GAB?
Well, it's critical with the state government pending to make a decision on the proposal for CO2 to be injected into the Great Artesian Basin, and that's something that no community in Queensland wants. I've just returned from a two-week study tour over in the States, and we attended the University of Texas in Austin. We spoke about it over there, about the very real risk that it poses to water aquifers. It is a common practice there, but not into aquifers that are used for stock and domestic. And so here in Queensland, it's our lifeblood, and we certainly don't want it to be put at any risk. That's why it's critical that the state make an urgent decision not to allow the injection of CO2 into the Great Artesian Basin.
That this approval would set a dangerous precedent for the Great Artesian Basin. And that's why, as local governments, we're standing against it. And not only should this application be rejected, but we know that legislation should be put in place to prevent this from ever occurring for the benefit of all the communities that thrive off the Great Artesian Basin.
Well, from a Gladstone point of view, we're leading the way when it comes to renewable energies and energy transition. What we don't want to see is the Great Artesian Basin ruined on the way through to chasing net zero by 2050. It's a target that we know we all need to achieve, but we don't want to see one of Australia's greatest assets destroyed in the meantime.